Even here in La Jolla, we will see the effect of the melting ice sheets, which is why it's super important for us to monitor sea level rise everywhere around the world, not just where the changes are occurring. My name is Helen Amanda Fricker. I'm a glaciologist, a professor at Scripps Institute of Oceanography. I work on the ice sheets of Antarctica and Greenland, and the main question there is how much ice is staying inside, locked up in the ice sheet, and how much is being melted out into the ocean. The way that we measure the mass or the volume of the ice sheets is using satellite data. So I came to Scripps to work on a project called ICESat, which is Ice Cloud and Land Elevation Satellite. It's NASA's first satellite laser altimeter mission. And now we have ICESat 2, which launched last year, and we're collecting data in a follow-on mission to map the Earth's ice sheets. So two of the projects that I've worked on recently, one is an airborne survey over the Ross Ice Shelf. The Ross Ice Shelf is the largest ice shelf in Antarctica. It's about the size of Texas or Spain. Another project which I'm involved in is fieldwork on a lake that I found using satellite data. So the ICESat instrument was able to detect a whole network of subglacial lakes underneath the Antarctic ice sheet. And now 10 or 12 years on from then, we've gone in and we've now drilled two of these lakes and collected samples of water from the lake and also sediments from the lake bed so we can understand how often that lake has drained in the past, how long it's been there for, where the water comes from, what lives in there, all these amazing questions. It's kind of like the most incredible example that I can think of that I've been involved with in human exploration of the planet.